Good morning, everyone. Any enterprise data platform is a crucial aspect of any organization's technology landscape that provides a central repository for all kinds of data. There are several benefits why organizations choose to build an enterprise data platform. Overall, an enterprise data platform helps organizations to maximize the value of the data by providing a unified and centralized approach to data management and analytics. Building an enterprise data platform on the cloud has several benefits over traditional on-premise solutions. It provides scalability, increased availability, improved security, integration with other cloud services for analytics, and several other benefits. In this short video, I would like to show how to build an enterprise data platform with just a click of a button. I am Prasanna Sridharan, working as a principal data architect in AWS. I want to introduce Atomix and one-click data framework, which enables enterprise customers build the data platform on the cloud with just one click of a button, which would otherwise take months to years of effort to build the same. As the name suggests, with one click, customers will be able to build an end-to-end data platform starting from data ingestion from various sources, data standardization, building data lineage, performing data governance, and data sharing to multiple other consumer accounts, which enables data mesh kind of an architecture, where multiple data producers can share the data to multiple other data consumers. So with one click, customers will be able to build their entire lakehouse platform, both data lake as well as data warehouse. We'll go over a scenario showing a journey of a data scientist building a machine learning model. Here we have John, who is a data scientist, wanted to build a machine learning model based on customer spending habits. So he wants to have access to customer demographics data and some transactions data to know on what products does customers spend on. He goes into the enterprise data platform and searches for the customer demographics data and customer transactions data. He was able to find customer transactions data in one of the data warehouse tables, but he doesn't have access to that. So he has to raise a request to get access to the transactions table. On the other hand, he couldn't find any table which contains customer demographics data in the enterprise data platform, but he knows that one of the on-prem databases in MySQL has got customer demographics information in the customer master table. First, he needs to bring in the demographics data from the on-prem database to the enterprise data platform. Even after bringing in the data, he will not have access to the table by default. So he has to raise a request to get access to the customer demographics data as well. Once the access goes through, he'll be able to access these tables from his own data science account, which enables him to build the machine learning model successfully. The overall process of bringing in the data from on-prem and getting access would take weeks to months of effort. Using Atomix, John will be able to bring in the customer demographics data from on-prem MySQL database, get access to the customer demographics data from the data lake, get access to the customer transactions data from the data warehouse, all of the above with just one click of a button. Let's get into the demo and see how John performs all the above actions using Atomix. John logs into the enterprise data platform account and search for customer demographics data and customer transactions data in both data lake as well as data warehouse. He couldn't find any database or tables related to customers in the data lake. So he moves on to data warehouse to check if he's able to find anything related to customers. He was able to find a table related to customer transaction, but he couldn't find anything related to customer demographics. He's aware that one of the on-prem database systems have information related to customer demographics. He logs into the on-prem database and finds a table called customer master, which has got the demographics information about all the customers. Now you need to bring in this data from the customer master to the enterprise data platform to develop his machine learning model. John logs into Atomix so that he can raise a request to bring in the customer master data from the enterprise data platform. Once he logs in, he sees the status dashboard. The dashboard displays the number of objects or tables that were brought into the data lake from various source systems. It displays the real-time progress of all the batch processes for the date selected, the number of new objects that were brought in for the date selected, number of objects where the data is refreshed from the source systems and its execution status of those batch process, and number of objects from the data lake that were shared to multiple other consumer accounts for the date selected, and number of objects from the data warehouse
that were shared to multiple other consumers for the date selected. So it's a one-stop dashboard where we can get the entire picture of the data lake platform. When you click on the object count or the object overview link, it displays the details for all the objects. You'll be able to find the source system, database, schema, and other details from where the object or table was brought in from. When you click on any of these object ID link, you'll be able to find more details about the object selected. Some of the controls here are editable, where you can modify and submit. You can modify the compute capacity, or you could modify the node type and submit. The updated value will be referred to in the subsequent execution of the object. In the object's overview screen, you'll be able to filter based on the various attributes. With multiple dynamic filters, you'll be able to sort on any attributes. You can also set your preferences to show on ID attributes and set your page size. All these navigational controls like dynamic filters, sorting, pagination, and preferences are available in all the screens in Atomix. When John searched for a particular object name called customers, he couldn't find any. So he clicks on the generate manifest files link, which opens up the onboarding form where you can enter the details of the object that you want to bring in. Currently, Atomix supports these source types from where you can bring in data from any of the flat files, any on-prem RDBMS databases like Oracle or SQL Server or MySQL or Postgres or any other databases which are JDBC compatible. You can bring in data from real-time change data capture from any of the on-prem RDBMS databases. In our case, John is trying to bring in data from MySQL database. So he chooses RDBMS batch option, which will display a simple form where you need to feed in the object details and submit. He's trying to bring in the data from MySQL. So he enters the source system name, database name, schema name, object name, schedule in which he wants to refresh the data, and few other information, and hit submit. Once submitted, you'll be able to track the progress of the data ingestion process by either clicking on the object onboarding summary screen or clicking on the link from the status dashboard. All the necessary AWS resources will be created during object onboarding process to bring in the objects from the on-prem source database. Object onboarding summary screen will display the overall status of the object onboarding process. Now the status is queued, which will be picked up in a minute. Let's refresh the screen. Now the status has changed to running, so the request is picked up and the onboarding process is in progress. If you click on the object onboarding link, it will open up the details screen where you find the step-by-step details of the object onboarding process. Every time you refresh, you will see the progress of the batch. It takes few minutes to complete for the object onboarding process. Now that it's complete, the status of all these steps have been changed to succeeded. You can also see the status of the summary as well, which is succeeded. You can click on the show button to see an high-level details of the onboarding process instead of going to the details screen. Now the object has been onboarded successfully, the object execution process will be picked up. The actual data will be transferred from the on-prem source to the enterprise data lake during the object execution process. Object execution screen will display the overall status of the object execution process. Now the status is queued, which will be picked up in a minute. Now the status has changed to running. So the request is picked up and the execution process is in progress. If you click on this object execution ID, it will open up the details screen where you'll be able to find step-by-step details of the execution process. Every time you refresh the screen, you'll be able to see the progress of the batch. Now that it is complete, you can see the status of the summary as well. It should have changed to succeeded. You can also click on the show to see high-level details of the execution process instead of going into the details screen.
Now we know that the customer master table has been successfully brought into the enterprise data platform. John can now try accessing these tables from the data science account. John is in the data science account. This is his machine learning notebook where he's going to do the model training and model development. When he tries to query the table, the customer master, he's getting an invalid request exception error since he does not have access to this table yet. Let's query the customer transaction table. He got a similar error, resource not found exception, for the same reason that he does not have access to these tables yet. Let's go back to Atomix and try to request access for these tables. I'm back to Atomix. And I am in the generate manifest file screen. Last time, John requested to onboard an object from the on-prem system. This time, since the objects are already available in the enterprise data platform, he needs to request the consumption access. Select the option object consumption. You will see there are two types. One for request access to the objects that are there in the data lake, and another one for requesting access to the objects that are there in the data warehouse. Let's try to raise the access request for the customer master table, which is there in the data lake. Once the option data lake is selected, fill up the necessary information and submit. We enter the database name, the object name that he wants to have access to, the role that you'll be using to perform this machine learning exercise, the account number from which you'll be performing this machine learning exercise. Fill up all the necessary details and click on submit. Once submitted, you can monitor the progress of the request by either clicking the data lake access summary link or link from the status dashboard. It works the same way as we saw during the object onboarding and execution process. In the data lake access summary screen, I filtered for the object name as customer master. The process has successfully ran and status has succeeded. You can click on the show button to see the eye level details for the progress, or you can also click on this permission ID, which will give you the step-by-step progress of the process in the detailed screen. John now has access to the customer master table. He now needs to request for customer transactions table, which is there in the data warehouse. He has to repeat the same step similar to the previous access request. He has to go back to the generate manifest file screen, click on the object consumption, and select the source type as data warehouse, and fill up the necessary information and submit. Similar to the data lake request, you will have to enter the source database name, schema name, object name, for which John is requesting for access to, along with producer information and consumer information, and hit submit. Once submitted, you can monitor the progress of the request by either clicking the data warehouse access summary link or the link from the status dashboard. It works the same way as we saw in the data lake access request process. In the data warehouse access summary screen, I filtered for the object name customer transactions. The process has successfully ran and the status has succeeded. You can click on the show button to see eye level details of the progress, or click on the permission ID, which will give you the step-by-step progress of the process. John now has access to both customer master as well as customer transactions table. He should now be able to access these tables and build his machine learning model successfully. So he's querying the customer master table. He's able to successfully fetch the record back, and he's also trying to fetch the data from customer transactions table, and he's able to fetch the records back. Now that he has access from both the tables, he can do all his transformations and machine learning model exercises using these objects. So using Atomix, John was able to bring in the customer demographics data from on-prem MySQL database, get access to the customer demographics data from the data lake, get access to the customer transactions data from the rich data warehouse, all of the above with just entering few information in a form and clicking a button. He doesn't have to write any code or spend time in bringing in the data or trying to get access to these tables. Thanks. That's the end of the short demo on Atomix.